Dear viewers, today we are going to see the embedded system subject at the basic of introduction to embedded system. And today's topic, unit number 1, introduction to embedded system topic. This syllabus is Anna University syllabus, Applied Engineering College syllabus. We are going to see one by one topic, right? So that is that, first of all, this is the introduction to that, to the embedded systems. So the embedded system, what is mean by the embedded system? So we have going to see the embedded system is a combination of that electric or electromechanical system. Not only for this, the embedded system is always the combination of both the software and hardware. Okay, so that is the software and the hardware. So any embedded system is the combination, that is the combination. Okay, combination of that is hardware and software, right? So that is the combination of this software and hardware. Okay, so that is the further the thing, that is the combination which have going to be given as, that is the concept of, which is a specific hardware, specific hardware which also going to be work within the specific software, that is the specific software. So that is a specific hardware which can be connected to that, that is a specific software. So if you need some example, so that is, if you are used in any pen drive, as like a pen drive, if you are going to insert the pen drive, the immediately the driver, that is the driver program, is automatically find and then loaded. So that is the hardware which can be encapsulated with the software, which is called the embedded system. Yeah, that is a hardware, which can be encapsulate with specific software, then it may be called as a pure embedded system. Okay, so that is that the mind, you have keep it in your mind. Okay, so that is the system which may be consists of that the electrical, that is the electrical, or that is the electromechanical system which may be used for actuator and other thing used, and which can be formed the specific function, that is the function is a specific function, it is not a general function, right? So this is the specific function is the used or combination of the both hardware and firmware, both the hardware firmware, which means that is the software, firmware. So this is called the embedded system, how it can be used. So that is the embedded system. Assume that is the we want to control, that is that the one DC motor, we want to control that is one DC motor. So this is that is the DC motor, you are well known. So we are going to be used, that is the field separately excitation. So I am also going to put one switch here. So this is the power electronics, that is power electronic switch. Okay, power electronic switch here. So I am also going to connect. Okay, so that is here, that is one speed sensor which is available. So this is that the sensor, this is the speed, that is the speed sensor, speed sensor which is available here, that is the number of sensors which can be taken as that the input, right? This is what is this, that is the speed sensor, that is the speed sensor which may be going to given to that our controller. So the output of the speed sensor is a analog, that is analog, that is the analog value. So this analog value which may be converted into analog to digital converter, because all the microprocessor and the microcontroller going to do that the processing the signal in digital manner only. Next, this is the MUPR MUC, that is the MUPR MUC. So this is assume this is MUP R, that is R, that is the MUC, the here that is available for the MUC, microcontroller or microprocessor. So again we have going to feed this. So we want to control, we want to control this, we want a control again this control which may be going to flow from this device, but at the same time that is the output of that the microprocessor or the microcontroller, that energy is not sufficient to switch on the power electronic device. For that purpose here we are going to put some driver. Okay, so what is the function of the driver? Suppose if you want to open the door, if you want to open the door, you may going to that is the asking to the one year child, that is 1 year, or you may going to assume that is 3 years old baby, 3 years old baby. He or she may going to obey your order. At the same time, he or she is not able to open the door. Suppose you may going to ask to one boy or girl, they may having at the age of 12 years old, that is 12 years old, definitely they are going to, they are able to open, they are able to open the door. So what is the both of them, they are also going to obey in our order, but the 12 year person which is also able to open the door, because they are having a sufficient energy, sufficient energy. So that the switch open and close, that is we need the sufficient energy for open and close the power electronic switch, that energy which is given by this driver circuit, but the signal which is maybe going coming to this microprocessor and microcontroller. Okay, this is the thing. And suppose if you have used some other water flow simultaneously, this motor which may be connected to that some other system, or we have going to connect that the system, we have going to provide that is that some same driver circuit. This circuit which may be going to actuator, AC actuators, right, actuator, and so on, that is different types of output device. Here the sensor, suppose if you are used in the human machine interface system, like a keyboard, keyboard or some other touch, that is touch screen, or any keypad, or that is any keypad, or that is switch, that is the different types of input device, different types of input device which may be going to use the give the input of the system, right? Okay, so this is the thing, because all this output are that is the this output which is called the digital output. Okay, digital out. So we don't need that the ADC conversion, but here that is the analog. So we are going to put this operations. So at the same time, if you need that the operation of some other the amplifier or some other circuit, we need the digital to analog converter, that is DAC DAC. So this DAC output which may be going to feed into the that is some audio amplifier or some other process we are going to be utilized. So this is the process. So the entire process. So the entire process that is the speed control of that DC motor which contains this sensor that is output switching driver that is that the that is any other informations through the DAC card and drive to the solenoid coil and it may be given human machine interface. So these are all the input system. So these are all the input. So again these are all these devices, these are all the output system. So the entire system which may be called as the embedded system. The entire system which may be called as this is that the system which is available here. The entire system. At the same time, we need the suitable program. What type of program we need? That is the software. So that is the software is required. So a software which can be encapsulated with the hardware. So this is that the hardware which is available here. That is the hardware which is available. Again, we are going to provide that is the software. This is the software. This is the hardware. Okay. Again, we need to store the that is our program. So for that purpose, we have need that some memory. Okay, memory. So this memory operation we can going to communicate. So all the device we need the power supply system. So I am going to give one power supply. That is what is this power supply unit. So I am going to connect all the system the required power which may be given by the power unit. So these are all the things. So this entire setup which may be called as the embedded system. So the now the embedded system which may be means as that is the limited hardware. At the same time the embedded system is a limited hardware and or software. That is a limited software. Then other than the personal computer. So that is, this is not as a computer. So it may be in the form of that the simple software and a simple hardware. The embedded system is designed to perform the dedicated specific work. The dedicated system, specific system. So which may be contains the analog to digital converter, digital to analog converters. So digital to analog conversion, analog to digital conversion, that is PWM, that is the counter, that is the amplifier, timer, filters, everything which may be available in the single environment. So this is that the concept of embedded system. Okay. Right. So this is the thing. Today's session we are going to be see what is the concept of that embedded system. Okay. So this is the basic concept of that the embedded system. Please see, this is the inputs. Inputs may be in the different types of sensors. That is different types. That is types of a sensor is used. Each system we need that the memory. So the memory to store and retrieve the program and the data. Both the program and data. That is under the data. Again it may be with the embedded firmware. If we are going to communicate with the others through that the USB or any other method of communication, that is a serial port. That is the serial ports which can be used. Again, that is the output of the system which may be in LED or LCD or again combo, that is TUCH, touch screen based, or if you have used in the buzzer. So different types of outputs we have going to consider. So the other supporting integrated system, suppose if you need the more than one process, we are going to connect the different types of different processor we are going to be used to. So depends upon the application, whether if you have used the FPGA, field programmable gate array, or ASIC, application specific integrated circuit, or DSP, digital signal processor. So this is SOC. Next one is, that is the microprocessor and microcontroller. Okay, so these are all the device, depends upon that our requirement we are going to utilize. Okay, so SOC means, that is system on chip. Okay, right. So these are all the things for introductions, that is introduction of the embedded system. Okay, please keep it your mind. So the embedded system is a system which can be combination of the software and hardware, which can be combination of that software and hardware with a specific function, with a specific specific function, that is very important thing. The function is a specific function. Okay, right.